Hi, this is Rosie Lerner, Purdue Extension consumer horticulturist. My colleagues and I would like to make you aware and explain some of the effects of the brutal winter of 2014 on your woody landscape plants. The extreme cold, coupled with unrelenting winds and the large amounts of salt that were applied to roads, sidewalks, and parking lots, are taking their toll on landscape plants this spring. As plants awaken from their winter slumber, branches that exhibit dieback or plants that fail to flower or leaf out may be observed. We are seeing considerable damage this year, and we expect to see more of it later on this summer. While it's difficult to determine the extent of winter injury until they actually break bud, now is that time for homeowners and green industry professionals to evaluate their plants for the damage and see what corrective measures might be needed. Plants are at their hardiest during winter dormancy. Unfortunately, that happens to be when the extreme cold temperatures occur. Plants that are adapted to the local area and that went into winter in good condition should have experienced relatively little damage. But plants that were stressed due to other factors, such as disease, insect pests, or the extreme drought of 2012, these plants were especially vulnerable to the extremes of this past winter. Some plants that are marginally hardy in our area may have previously survived in winters that were relatively mild. But this year, these plants could die or sustain significant damage, including dieback all the way to the ground as a result of the harsh winter. Although plants are dormant during the winter months, the plant tissue still is subject to losing too much water, a condition called desiccation, and especially from frigid temperatures coupled with strong winds. Evergreens, especially broadleaf evergreens such as rhododendron, mahonia, boxwood, and holly, are the most susceptible because they have greater leaf surface through which they lose water compared to deciduous plants, which drop their leaves as they prepare for dormancy. This year's unusually heavy and consistent snow cover actually did provide very good insulation, and so most plants went into winter with good moisture supply and this extra insulation from snow cover. But when the ground is frozen solid and there's sub-freezing temperatures for an extended period of time, accompanied by these high winds, the plants continue to lose moisture without being able to replenish the supply. The result is desiccation, which is also commonly called winter burn, and this looks just like the plant tissue has been scorched. Plants such as yew or taxus could also be damaged from de-icing salts that were frequently applied this winter to roadways, sidewalks, and parking lots. So the plants that are along these salted surfaces may show damage that looks a lot like drought symptoms or damage to the root system. If you suspect a salt buildup, additional watering to leach the salts out of the root zone can help reduce these toxic concentrations and improve growing conditions. We recommend delaying and using conservative pruning practices this spring so that the toll of winter injury can be accurately assessed. Cutting into live green tissue at this time could further cause damage and may also remove new shoots and leaves that are going to be critical for recovery, especially if there's been a lot of dieback. Dead branches can be removed anytime, but be aware that many plants have been very slow and late to break out of dormancy this year. You can always prune more later as needed, but be conservative now. We advise homeowners and green industry professionals to not overreact to the damage by applying too much fertilizer, either too early or in excessive amounts. People have their heart in the right place, they want to help their plants, but it takes a lot of energy away from the plants to process this additional nutrition, and this could further delay recovery of the plants. Well, we want to make sure you realize that hope is not lost, because the good news is most of your plants should have remained unscathed this spring, and many that were damaged can still make a pretty good recovery. There may be some plants that have just completely died, but usually those are the ones that went into winter in relatively poor health to begin with. If you would like assistance in assessing the health of your plants, you can submit a sample for diagnosis by the Purdue Plant and Pest Diagnostic Laboratory, and there is a nominal charge. And if you'd like more additional information on winter injury of ornamentals, we do have an article for you to read. Just come and visit our website.